Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
There he is.
There he is.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. For the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
Found a way
to climb the tower.
The ladder.
Quick. What now?
You can see it. A line to the truth. The bridge.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the Death Moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. That is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the Death Moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
Come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there? Come out if you are.
Where is he? Find him.
You have to find him.
What's the rules?
Dillian!
Too much.
They're coming for me!
No, you don't.
It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
Can you feel it?
You'll die.
Can you feel it?
You're dying. The burning
She's
has begun.
The burning.
The burning has begun.
Go to the gate. There they are. The rooms. It is.
Go towards it.
Run.
Focus.
Find
focus.
It.
Focus. Focus.
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. That doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
Killing you would be too easy.
They're taking your memories to torture you.
They're taking your body inside.
You're disappearing one memory
at a time.
Every time you remember, it disappears.
They're going to take everything.
They're not yours anymore.
They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
They belong to the gods, not to you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul.
They want to crush it.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest. say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me? I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. And there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I can't go on. Lillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. The breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Good.
Reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. And no coward. Prove that from the Memorial Tribe. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides,
I'll do my best.
seems there's no escaping the past in this place. So she's forced to relive it. To what end? There is a house.
Don't be afraid.
Tilly, there's something in you.
Do you see it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it, one step at a time.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
There is more of them. I think they're moving.
You're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
Listen to the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. Do this anymore.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
Thank you.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And his sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Nothing lives here. You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood.
Dillion gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back, go back.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
But years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. The plague.
Tell you?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get to you.
Hold your heavy strike.
Hold it.
Hold the heavy strike.
Hold it. Hold your
hold
it.
Hold your heavy. Unleash the sword.
Must remember, she can throw this inside.
Over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone a secret. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Suffering, Senua. Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?